Anna?
Anna?
Okay. Okay, νομίζω είναι καλύτερα τώρα. Ωραία. Where is Σκούλη? Σκάλη. Is he here? Oh. Oh, okay. Let me see a minute. Well, yes, I should, I guess. But no life signs. Oh, oh, okay. I like your dislikes. So hello all. My name is Dominique, by the way, just in case. How are you doing all? Why my face? Why? I assume you already know how it will look. I wanna see. Damn. Catch me if you can. Hello there, officially. Yeah, now you can feel it's like more in person, I guess. I don't think so. By the way, you just woke up, Scully. Basically, Rachel. Let's say Rachel. No, it's not an original, obviously. It's a fake one. Yeah. So, actually, there are many topics to cover. Which one should you suggest to start? Okay, no Rachel, no. All right. Let me place this here. Okay. Nervous? No. No. Why it should be? What do you think there is in my inventory? Yeah, it's my dog. Yeah. Πού είναι ο πουμπής? Τι είναι? Όχι. Μαμά, τώρα μιλά, αφού μιλήσαμε. Ναι, φύγει τώρα. Το μπούμπι θέρα μου. Something in Greek. Just call my dog. He's on his way. He's just out in the yard playing. We talked about this. Okay. Bobby? Έλα. Έλα. Εδώ. Απ. Oh. Okay, you can't see him, but I think you can see him now. No, you can't. Why? Έλα, έλα πάνω. There he is. Oh, he's a Labrador. Half, actually, half Labrador. Yeah. Oh, his name? Yeah, his name is like that. Ah, my sister. Yeah, it was my sister. Yeah, this actually is my dog's name. I already did. Pretty much everything. Actually, I want you to ask questions. It would be great. All right, what do I need here? Okay. Let me see a moment. Let's place this here, and this one, right, okay, I guess it's good here, all right. Six people. Oh, yeah. I don't know. I don't know who are they. So, we should start, I guess. Basically, do you have any specific topic you'd like to start from? Yeah, the best ships. Um, As far as I remember, I play the game for about 1 year. So I actually have spent very much time, too much time in game, like farming and stuff, completing a bunch of events every month, especially after the previous winter. I start the game. Now we have 25th of September, so no need to recover my stamina. So I start the game about exactly 1 year ago. Yeah, it doesn't actually need to restore it. Trust me, not gonna use it. So. Yeah, after level 18 to 20, I started progressing really, really, really fast. I remember myself getting in Savage Alliance. So I was in the alliance about 6 months, I guess. I think. Yeah. So, all this high progress actually came from seed events. I don't know if some of you remember that if you complete a seed event, you actually take really high rewards, like a bunch of blueprints, which is about 100 blueprints. Like, if you take this every month, it's a lot. And upon completion of this event, you take about 20k stones of blacksmith. So, yeah, that's also a lot. As about bloody coins, yeah, this is another topic. So, actually, these ships, which is four of them, and to be honest, on this level, I have the right to complete one more. So, I have already four, and I can complete one more, but honestly, I don't really need that. And, I mean, I have the blueprints to upgrade one more ship, but it's not necessary. It's actually a really bad move to do, because when you attack in a territory, you only use one fleet, actually. So, you need only one fleet strong to be strong. The others are just for farming. So yeah, when that's the reason I'm telling you that monster rides are important, because the rewards you take when you use Calypso on this event are really high, and it can really help you progress really, really fast. So yeah. Let me try. I don't think it's gonna work. Where are you? There you are. Yeah. It's not supported. Yeah, I don't think you can transfer blueprints. Blueprints value is actually really, really high. So, yeah. Yeah, so let's see. So, do you have actually any preference about topic discussion? I mean, do you want to start from ship upgrades or mermaid or territory upgrade or monster hunting? What would you like? Okay. That's a good start, I guess. Okay, let's start from ship upgrades. All right. So mermaid, you want little injuries? Yeah. not really easy. So let's start 1-1. Let's start from ship upgrades. So as far as you can see, pretty much every ship I have is actually really high level, especially those ships, those five ships are called unique because of the special abilities they have, like this one, Dutchman, has armor. Gives armor, but only to itself. So it's not a bad ship. Also about this, about Jack Sparrow, which it's actually your favorite, as far as I know, it gives you evasion. This one decreases your evasion. Not your evasion, enemy evasion. And you know the rest. So let's start before we upgrade the ships. So when it comes to ship level up, the cost is pretty, you cannot change that, you cannot lower it, it's pretty much standard. Essence of the Sea, Cannons, and these three are pretty much standard. You cannot get them lower at cost. So before you do every ship upgrade in here, which I'll tell you later which one are the important ones, you actually need to have about, I think, 50 level, 50 captain level, I think, I'm not sure, but I think with 50 captain level, you can actually do this, you can actually max this here, decrease ship upgrade cost, and this buff is the exist one, I think it's one, yeah, one, two times, three, four, what, four, yeah, four times, and one more, yeah, five times. So this buff exists five times here, six, okay, it's six times, all right. So I don't remember very well, but I think that if you reach level 50, you can have the necessary points, so you can upgrade the skills. Now, these skills are really useful, and it actually lowers the cost of these upgrades, really, dramatically. So in my opinion, before you start upgrading anything on your ship, it should be great if you reach your captain about level 50. It's probably the first step you should start. It only works for these upgrades. Now, if you're about to upgrade your ship level, it's not gonna work there. It just won't. So let's talk about what upgrade you should do in the first place. Now, when I start playing, and I was asking what upgrades are the most important, and I remember many people told me that you actually have to fully upgrade ship versus ship power, armor, durability, and evasion. Now, the thing is that durability and armor are not really important, and the reason behind of this is actually because under level 28, every ship you have, it's actually pretty weak. So no matter the upgrade you are gonna do, it's not gonna be that much of a difference. I mean, okay, there is a small difference, but you are not gonna notice it. No way. So my thoughts about it is the only upgrade you should do in the first place, it's only ship versus ship power. Maximize it, especially this one. It's really important. And evasion. Evasion is actually the best and first one you should upgrade. And max, of course. Because it helps almost everywhere in territory attacking or monster hunting. So yeah, it's pretty useful. And the third upgrade, which is the more important in every ship, it's hunting rewards. This is a must, and it's actually really useful. Now let me tell you why this is really important. I'm not gonna lie. Now, every month, yeah, I have made a subscription in game. So every month I pay about €3 for this subscription, which is not much. It's like it has the cost of a coffee. It's nothing, actually. So for me, it's worth, and I don't really actually care about those €3. Doesn't matter. So this one gives me actually hunting rewards plus 10. So for me, it's a bit necessary in the situation I am right now, because I have already maxed my ship's upgrades, so I cannot really change them. It's not profitable for me to change my upgrades anymore. For you, it's not really necessary to use money. And that's why I'm telling you this. So, when you actually farm monsters, you can see that let's see. I know you can buy 2 birds for €3. I know, but I mean, it's not much for me, at least. It's not much. Yeah, so I want you to see something. As you can see, now I want you to calculate something. Let's start from these two ships, Black Pearl and Flying Dutchman. You can see that I have maximized hunting rewards in both ships. I've done this because those two ships are the perfect ships for monster hunting. Literally, the armor this ship provides, it's really great. And the evasion of these ships also helps a lot, having less injuries. Almost one bread? Yeah. Well, actually, I can't buy about six bread. Six breads or three, depends. Alright, so let's take this one. It's 12% from this one, right? So let's go here and take two more ships. I have 12% on this ship too. So 12 plus 12 is 24. And I have one more 12%. That's 36%. Now, in order to actually reach the best percent about hunting rewards, you need to have at least, basically you need to have all five ships and at least 12 percent. So 12 is 36 plus this one, it's 3 for me, plus this one, it's 6, make us 9. So we have 9% plus 36, it's 45. Now, how much do you need? You need 10 more. 20, yeah, all right. So, having that much of hunting rewards, I will catch tacticians later too, no worries. When you farm monsters, like now, you can actually take double rewards. So that means that, let me show you. So when you actually hunt a monster, you might get double tickets, like those tickets. Every ticket of this one, you might take double of them. Basically, you always get double. So you need about you need exactly 55%. On hunting rewards, so you can take double rewards in every from every monster. You just send five ships, and yeah. Well, so about the next upgrade, in my opinion, is important. Second important is the evasion ability. It's really useful because it helps you have less injuries in almost everything you do, from monster hunting and territory attacking, everything. And if you have enough points, the third one you should do is ship versus ship power. Okay. Oh no. Okay, we shall continue. All right. So I guess you can still hear me, right? I had a small issue. All right. Okay. Okay. Good. So, about ship upgrades, yeah, these three are the most important in my opinion. First of all, hunting rewards. If you manage to achieve with 5 ships about 55%, it's probably the best thing you can do. So, second one is always evasion. Maximize it is pretty important. Third, in my opinion, is ship versus ship power. And now, all the others are depends on the way you play the game. For me, I don't know if he's here. For me, the best upgrade is cabin, pirate capacity. So I'm sure you have noticed that I have a bunch of pirates in literally every ship, a ton of them. Like in this one, I have almost 10k pirates. This is a lot. So, yeah, it's pretty important. Now, let me tell you about this. I don't know if you were online that day, but I remember myself talking about it, and I was saying that actually the more pirates you have in your ship, it's probably the best, in my opinion, the best thing you can do, because the more pirates you have, if your ship survive in a battle, then guess what will happen? Then, you know, the pirates of enemy ships and your ships actually fight together. So, if you have enough pirates to withstand the attack, you actually are going to demolish them. Let me show you this one. Let me show you an attack. Let me see, show you what I mean. So, in this ship, imagine I have 5k, almost 40k, 45k pirates in all ships. So, let's take a close one. I guess this one might be good. This one is good one. Okay, let's see how this is gonna go. He's SP3. I think I have him. I think I can beat him. Now. So yeah, his damage is a bit high. I'm just hoping these two recover my durability. No, never. Never? Wow, okay. Completely flayed. Failed. Let me see. No, yeah, that was actually pretty bad. So, yeah, I'm not gonna win this. There is no way. He's actually has too much research. It's basically the ship difference we have. Okay, let's see another battle. Let's take, not this one, this is too weak. Okay, let's take this one. This has to be, this is equal. Let's see. Yeah, all the way, yeah, of course, great job. Okay, let's see. Come on. Okay, one is down, I think. Okay, we are 4 versus 4 ships. Okay, that's perfect. Okay, let's start with this one. So it's about 9,000 pirates against 5,000 almost. So it's, yeah, that's pretty much a win for this duo. Let's go next ship battle. Okay, probably he lost the other ship, so this one is gonna be actually really bad for him. Like, watch. Yeah, okay, yeah, he doesn't stand a chance. Like, literally, zero. Especially with the number of tough pirates I have here, he has no chance. Zero chances. So, having more pirates, it's good. It's really good. But if you combine them with two specifically tacticians, which is these two, these Samuel Packers, it's great. What do I mean? So if you see here, in these two ships, if I remember well, yeah, I have placed simple pirates in these three ships, and that's because these tacticians are not the best, in my opinion. So, Samuel Packers are really strong in literally every fight, and that's because on every hit they do, they recover durability on your ship. So, in these two ships, the best move you can do is to put your strongest pirates, which I have done, in these two ships, because in almost every battle, these two ships will survive. These three might not, but these two will survive, pretty much always. So, no matter what, your pirates will survive too. And having strong pirates in these two ships, it's gonna make a difference, a really strong difference. Don't worry, there is actually there is an option. So for that, now about tacticians, if you don't have Samuel Packer, you can always use these ones, these tacticians, Man War, TIR. One, I have three of them. Where is the third? Ah, one, two, three. Green, blue, and purple. So these three, if you see, what they say, attack one enemy ship and recover your ship durability. Depends on your ship power. When your durability drops below 40%. So this is actually pretty good tactician, really useful. In my opinion, if you don't have Samuels, it's fine. You can always upgrade these three. 1, 2, 3. They are tier 4. And as far as I can say, they were pretty useful to me. Because green and purple actually are the best ones. The blue one, it's a bit lower, but three of them can keep your ship alive for a good amount of time in battle. Also, yeah, for you, don't do what I do. Play always with Jack Sparrow as your main ship and David Jones. These ships are really, really, really good. And in case you don't know, Jack Sparrow recovers a really small amount of durability, but David Jones does that too. So, where is it? Yeah, recover your ship durability by 30% if your ship durability is 35% or below. So, these two tacticians are really good in my opinion for starting your journey. So yeah, if you combine these two, basically, I'm pretty sure that at 28th level, most of you, basically all of you, have already two complete fleets. So you have five ships, five and five. So yeah, you can use these two, plus these three. Also, for your level, another good tactician, it's this one, Sophia. Actually, I have three of them, yeah, one, two, if you wonder why I have these two in low level, the rest of them, it's because it's not worth for me anymore to upgrade them, so I don't really care. Damian. Okay, give me... Oh, also, a really good tactician you can use, it's Lily Brown. She's actually really, really, really strong. Both of them. The white one and the green one. They're awesome, honestly. And that's because they actually buff your ship, evasion. She's actually debuffing enemy ship and also buffs your ship with evasion. And the thing is that if you combine Lily Brown with the couple, Tanner and Elizabeth, they're actually doing a pretty good, combination. Because Elizabeth also increases your evasion, all the fleet evasion. So it's pretty good, in my opinion. So yeah, if you have in one fleet Jack Sparrow, Elizabeth, Tanner, and where is she? One Lily Brown, and probably, yeah, one Manhor, it's actually a really good fleet to start with. So you told me about Damian. Yeah, okay, give me a moment. Where is he? I think it's Tyre. What tire is he? What is Damian? I don't see any Damian tactician. Yeah. Anyway, the Arab guy, which one? Can you tell me names? Okay, let me see. I don't have this tactician, so let me see if it is here. Sada. Oh. Okay, let's see. Is he tier 5 or 4? Oh, this one. Really? You have this one? Oh. Yeah, instead of these two, Manhor, you can actually use him. Yeah, he's pretty good too. It's just, Most people prefer to use purple tire or white, and that's because these tacticians are pretty much balanced compared to colored tacticians like blue, green, and stuff. Oh, Damon. Oh, okay, this one. Yeah, as far as I see, because he's recovered durability too, basically, if your tactician recovers durability, it's a must in your fleet. You should use him. Really. They're actually pretty good. It's just, you know, the amount of durability recovery is not that high. So, they are good tacticians, but not the greatest. So, if it happens you to take Samuel, Samuel tacticians are actually the best tacticians because they recover one fourth of your durability. So, for my ships, which my durability on every ship is about 200,000, he recovers about 55 to 60k durability. Well, that's a lot. So every time he shoots against the enemy, he recovers one fourth of the amount. So they are pretty useful. That's why I have placed all my strong pirates in their ships. So what else? So in my opinion, in your main fleet, at your level, you should use Jack Sparrow or David Jones. Especially Jack Sparrow, because he is immune to damage sometimes. You know, you have probably seen that he's if someone attacks him, he creates a shield around the ship, and he avoids most of the attacks. So that's really, really, really good. So you can combine Jack Sparrow with Elizabeth and Tanner. Yeah, in a minute I will talk about mermaids too. Elizabeth, Tanner, and then two other tactician of your choice that recover durability too. Well, for me at least, I'm not using them anymore because I have higher tactician, so it's not really good for me to use them. They're not good enough for me. So, also about the fleet, about your fleet. So, I don't know how easy it is for you to farm resource islands, but upgrading your first fleet, it's probably the best thing you can do so far. Like having one unique ship upgraded and four of these, 1, 2, 3, and 4 on probably level 20 to 22 level, having your main fleet is great. It's great. And after that, you can probably upgrade the rest of your fleet until a specific level. It can be 12, 15, 18. I think it's good enough until 18 level. So, yeah. About mermaids. Okay. Let's start from this one. I'm sure you are all familiar about this one. You can check the time of mermaid by the skill cooldown, daily skill cooldown. So, I don't know if you know, but every day we do mermaid, the time extends about 10 minutes more. So the cooldown is 24 hours and 10 minutes every day. That's why we cannot be late in Mermaid. That's why we have to be online the exact time. So right now it's in 5 hours and 4 minutes. That means, yeah. Okay. So about pirates. What can we say? Oh. By the way, Sparrow, I think I can see you. There you are. Hi there. What are you doing in my base? Just walking around. I'm a frog in there. Do some work. So about mermaids. Yeah. So, we all know the location of Mermaid, obviously. Of course, you know that if you complete 300k, you get about 2.5 million wood daily. In my opinion, this is really important. Like, no matter how much pirate injuries you get, it will always be worth to get those 2.5 million wood, because the upgrades you're gonna do from now on, especially from level 26 and higher, requires tons of wood. So much wood. Really too much wood. So participating daily, it's really important in my opinion, if you can participate, of course. Also, yeah, if you reach 300k, it's not worth to go for more. It's not profitable. So about the injuries in Mermaid, you cannot actually avoid injuries. You will always have injuries in Mermaid. So the best thing you can do, the best thing we can do, is actually to upgrade this one, to upgrade this skill in Alliance Research, which is, I think it's on Pirates. Yeah, it's on Pirates. So when I got in your Alliance and you gave me a part of your leadership, I opened this specific skill. So right now, we have, on every attack we do, we have about 80% less injuries. So, for example, when I attack Mermaid, I get about 1,500 injuries. So for me, obviously, this is not much, but for you, it might be. If I remember well, you get about 10,000 injuries. About 10,000 injuries, yeah. So that's a lot for you. I understand, yeah. So the best thing we can do is to start this skill. Yeah, 18k are a lot. Yeah, I know. So let me open this skill, because honestly, we're gonna need that. If we maximize this one, we get about 30% less injuries. So the thing is that it requires a bunch of research, donations. Yeah, so it might take a while to maximize it. I think one and a half month, I think it will be enough. Also, this is a nice skill. Okay, this is really good. One more thing, you can actually donate. I don't have donations. I don't need to donate. Yeah, I always donate. Also, yeah, about donations. I'm sure you know that it resets every 4 hours. Every 4 hours, you can go and donate whatever you like. Also, when you donate, I will. When you donate, you actually get more points. But you get more points in this one, in skills, alliance points. The more you donate, the more points you get. And also, sometimes, I'm sure you have noticed that you get boxes or 2 times, or 8 times, or 4 times, or 10 times, or gold. So this actually gives you, give us way more points in alliance points. So no need to rush it. Like, let's see this one. Where is it? Yeah, let's see if we see something. Wow, actually nothing. Wow, okay. No luck. Better luck next time. Okay. So, the first thing we can do is to maximize this skill, so you have less injuries. The next thing you can do... now, this is the difficult part. This is really difficult, actually. It's not gonna be easy for you, for most of you, actually. If we go to equipment, there is one equip. Basically, now there are two, but at your level, you can build a masterpiece equipment level 12. You build this, and actually the effects are really good. So as you see, on tie, even from tier 3, it gives you mermaid buffs. So it's about 5% pirate damage decreasing. In raids, boss monster, monster hunt, it's actually really good. I mean, I don't know about what is your master level. Mine are almost maxed, but once I achieved, you know, level 12, I created this equipment, which for me it was really important. So yeah, the higher you get, the more buffs that you take. Tier 3 it's not bad. Also, tier 5 is not bad too. And to be honest with you, after tier 6, it gets a bit difficult to upgrade. So you are gonna need some blacksmith stones to do that. In my opinion, it's a good equipment. And for me, it's my basic equipment, like for everything. From territory attacking and monster hunting, boss monsters and everything. And in this tier, it's about... it decreasing my pyre damage about 30%. So if you add this 30% and okay, game closed, give me a minute. So yeah, if you add equipment 30% and alliance research, which I hope we maximize it, 30% and 30% is gonna be 60% pirate injuries less. That's a lot. That means that from 80k it goes down to 10k, 9k. Yeah, it's about 9, it's around 9k damage pirates. So it's pretty good. So also in mermaid you can use, basically always use, Black Bear and Flying Dutchman. These ships are great for mermaid. So the reason behind this is because black pearl provides you with evasion, and evasion helps your ship pirates. Yeah, it helps to have less injuries. The same goes for Flying Dutchman. The thing is that Flying Dutchman has only ship armor, but you don't take a buff from his ship. You take the buff from Tactician Upgrade, which is this one. So if you have this Tactician upgraded, it gives you Pirate Attack and Death about 5%, which is actually a pretty decent amount to use. So if you use 5% from here, 30% from Alliance, and about 30% from equipment, or however, whatever you can, I mean, even Tier 5 is really good, because it gives you decreased fire damage. What else it gives you, if I remember well? Pirates death during hunting. Doing mermaid also counts as a monster hunt. So you also have 30%, 35% more death on your pirates. So like 35%, 10% from here, 5% from tactician. This is, it all gathers up, and it's really, it's much, it's enough. And you know, you can also have 30% HP, pirate HP. This is actually a pretty decent amount. And trust me, it will help you a lot. The difference is gonna be really big. Even in tier 5, you don't really need to go for tier 7. I did that because I was lucky enough. Honestly, I didn't have to spend a bunch of blacksmith to do that. So, tier 5 is pretty much decent. It's good. And, oh, by the way, take a note on that, and never, never combine your materials. Never. Do never do that. And I will tell you exactly why to not do that. I've done this mistake way too many times, and in my opinion, it's not worth. The thing is that when you combine them, you get this full green material, which in that case, if you have six of them, six greens, it guarantees a tier 3 equipment. The thing is that tier 3, it's pretty low, and you can even upgrade it with 1,000, 2,000 blacksmith is not much. I mean, you can afford it, obviously. So it's not really worth. So it's way better to lose the materials on this specific. Anyway, leave it like that. Never transformer to anything higher. Now, what about this? For me at least, when I did that mistake, it actually caused me a problem. The thing is that right here, for tier 12, 13, 5, 15, 20 level equipment, you don't need to have upgrades on your materials. These two, the simple ones, do the job really good. So if you ever reach 30, the game demands you to use only green ones. Now, crafting green materials, I mean, combine them to green materials, it's really expensive, because you're gonna need so many, and they're not gonna be enough. So in your case, I would prefer to keep the materials the way they are, in their first original πώς το λένε, wait a minute, where are you, okay, yeah, on their original form, and just keep crafting. I mean, save your materials and do craft, lots of craft if you want. And just this is a really good way to start start leveling up your master equipment. What power exactly? What do you mean? What kind of power are you referring to? This power? The main pirate power. Oh, this one. Yeah. So this amount of power actually comes up from everything you have, from research, from equipment, from captain level. This is captain level, which mine is 6-1, from your territory upgrades, from pirates. This is for only for your pirates. I mean, the defense, the HP, the attack. So this is only from pirates. And your fleet, of course. The fleet power. Which fleet powers actually is going up from upgrades, from ship levels and stuff. Oh, and also, this fleet power counts only the common ships you have, only these ones. The unique ships doesn't count. They don't. Unique ships, I think, goes in territory power. I'm not sure about that, but I think they are a part of your territory power. To be honest with you, it doesn't matter how much power you have. Honestly, it doesn't matter. It really doesn't matter. So, this is actually a thing to just show off in your server. Like, my power, it's... Yeah, my power... Where am I? Power level ranking? Yeah, I am at 14. I mean, we have this guy who has 4 millions of power. This is a lot. This is a lot. And then we have lower players like me and others too, as you see. So in my opinion, it doesn't really matter. Oh, also, upgrading your tacticians gives you territory power because they are part of your territory. They never leave. That's why. So, let me tell you this. If you ever manage to reach a master level for equipment at 12, first thing you have to do is to build this equipment. You don't need to go for tier higher than 5. Tier 5 is great. Really, it's great. It's not gonna cost you much to upgrade it to tier 5. It's pretty cheap and it's pretty useful. You will see that. I mean, imagine that right now we do monster rides and Skooli has basically Rachel has about 100 injuries. If you place the equipment, you're gonna have about 65 around there. So it's pretty good. Also, when you do monster hunt, it decreases way too much your injuries. So you can actually hunt higher monsters. But it's not really my point here. You also can see that on tier 5 you can get about, how much do you get? About 20% XP. So it's good. Now about this equipment. If you ever willing to go for tier 7, You need to have at least 100,000 stones in your inventory, at least. And the reason behind that is that you are gonna need this one, hunting rewards. Yeah, it's weird too. I never knew your name. So, right now, in my opinion, instead of making this equipment, another great equipment, it's this one. As far as I remember, both of you are level 28. So I bet, no, I don't bet. I'm sure you can afford this one equipment. Seasoned Pioneers equipment set. This equipment is really good. It's actually really good. I mean, it's really helpful in almost every situation. The reason behind that is because it gives you a small buffs, like in hunting, voyage speed, trading stamina. When you actually, right now we have merchant ship event, so when you use this equipment, whenever it's time to send your ship in a town to trade the materials you have, it decreases every round -4 in tier 6. In tier 7, it's the same. And also, the next event after merchant ship is the Notorious Pirate event. So, yeah, I will tell you about that too. So if you ever planning to make an equipment, in my opinion, start from this one. Right now you are 28. Right now you are 28 level, as far as I know. And making this equipment tier 7 is pretty easy, because on every upgrade you're gonna need about 7,000 blacksmiths to upgrade it, which is not much. And you have actually 70% rate success to upgrade it. So it's pretty easy to make it until tier 7. I mean, in my, for me, I use this equipment literally every time. Literally every time. In every event. Basically in merchant ship event. For me, it's really important. And to maximize it to tier 7, it's not gonna cost you more than 50,000 blacksmith. So yeah, it's easy. About equipment now, in my opinion, this is the most important equipment, because at least I use it all the time. These two, the tier 12 from Masterpiece, and level 28 Pioneer Seasoned equipment. These two are the most useful equipments for me. So now, the third equipment you should build at level 28, and this is a must, because as far as I can see, you want to go level 30. So, before you upgrade any other building in your base, what is the name? I don't remember. Not this one. Where is it? No, this is for research. So you're gonna need to build a level 28 seasoned architect's equipment set. This is also pretty easy to make to tier 7. It's not gonna cost you more than 50,000 blacksmith stones. It's pretty cheap, it's pretty easy, and it's pretty easy to go tier 7. Really, really easy. This also equipment has 70% success rate. So even if you fail, the next upgrade is gonna be guaranteed upgrade for sure. So this one is your priority right now. In my opinion, it's your first priority. The thing is that when you upgrade this equipment to tier 7, it gives you these buffs. So, decreases construction cost about 46%. 46% plus, where is it? Plus this one, 12.5, 3 times. So all this amount make us in the total of, let me see, where is it? Territory, we need territory, where is it? Territory, yeah, it's here. So, decreases construction cost about 38% without the suit. With the suit, it goes about, let's see. It goes about 120%. This is a lot. That means that if your territory, if a building of your territory requires about 20 million food to upgrade the building, it's gonna go down to 10, at least 10. And trust me, that's a big difference, upgrading your building. I mean, you can upgrade all your base with the half amount of resources. This is a lot. So as you can see here, I have my equipment cost decrease, which is 36 plus 46. We have that buff also from Alliance Research, which is 8%. We can also increase that. What else? Obviously, I have 30% more from my research, and all this adds up to 120%, which is a lot. I mean, let's see a building. Okay, let's see this one. Let's see without the equipment. So, this one requires for one upgrade 26 million. My God, that's a lot. Let's say we use the equipment right now. 16. It's about 10 million down. That's a lot. I mean, I can upgrade all the building 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 times. 5 times 5 to 16 must be 80 million food, which without the equipment, it's 125 million food. I mean, without the equipment, you're gonna spend about 55 million food more. So, yeah. In your case, I wouldn't upgrade any more buildings. Anymore. I will try to reach my lore collection to level 28. Probably my healer's capacity to 28. Gate is useless. You don't need to upgrade it. What else? Oh. And prison camp, yeah. This is pretty useful. You can upgrade that too. Also, on 28 level, if I remember well, you can build up 8-hour speedups. That's another really useful thing to do. I'm actually building speedups like every day, all day. For 8 hours, you are gonna need 4 hours to craft it. So it's worth it. What else? What else you can build at level 28, which is gonna be a worth move? Yeah, the lighthouse. Lighthouse is really important too, because every level you upgrade it gives you more free explore available. Now, for me, which I use it all the time, it's pretty much important. For you, I don't know how important it might not be. And all this because if you reach zero, then you start using gold. And gold is not really is not really easy to find, to be honest. I mean, every day I watch some ads from here, and I get double rewards from for gold. This is one way to have some gold. Also, when we complete Mermaid, we get some gold. We get gold as a reward. What else? Basically, yeah, I wouldn't actually rush my buildings at level 28. Only the prison camp, lore collection, and my dog. These three. Shipyard now, I don't remember if I need, if you need that. Yeah, I think you need that. Yeah, yeah, and shipyard. So, shipyard, dock, prison camp, forge. And if you want, you can go for lighthouse too, as the last one. About the rest, around here, I don't think you need to do that. I mean, for me, I don't mind upgrading everything to level 30. I just have better things to spend my resources. So yeah, you upgrade only this one, only these buildings. Shipyard, dock, forge, and prison camp. Nothing else. These four are really more than enough. Also about healer's hat, if you feel you have a problem with pirates, with injuries on your pirates, you can go for it too. You can upgrade that too. It's not a problem, obviously. But yeah, before you do anything else on territory upgrades, build your equipment to tier 7. It's really important before you upgrade anything else to go for this equipment. It's okay to leave all the rest of the buildings unupgraded because you are not gonna get any value from them. So yeah, if I remember well, you have this at level 27, this pirate. She's pretty good actually. Yeah, so you don't need to upgrade this building more than 27. Okay, so as far... So until now, the best equipment you actually can upgrade, it's the Seasoned Architects. I repeat, it's not gonna take you more than 50,000 stones to upgrade it to tier 7. It's pretty easy. Also, yeah, it's actually your first priority, in my opinion. Second priority, it can be your masterpiece, captain's equipment. Not level 7, not tier 7, but at least tier 5. It will be useful. And third priority, it's gonna be level 30, but this is gonna be way later, after you hit level 30. So it's not really a big of a deal. So yeah, let's go here. So first equipment, it's Seasoned Architect. Second equipment, it's Master level 12 Captain Masterpiece equipment for Mermaid and Monster Hunt. Third equipment you need to upgrade is this one, because you are gonna need this equipment to do your research much cheaper and stuff. So tier 7, it's pretty good. It goes really easy in tier 7. It's not gonna cost you more than 50k blacksmith too. And it also reduces the bloody coins cost. As you see, it's about 10% down. So it's a really good amount, trust me. Let's see in research how much difference does it make. So let's go, let's see, we go here. So okay. As far as okay, we see that if we want to upgrade something like this one, okay, we're gonna need about 1,000 bloody coins, which is a lot, and the rest of the resources, which also are a lot. So if we use the equipment, which is tier 7, it goes down by 100. It might not seem that much, but it is definitely worth it, because as the time goes, you're gonna need more and more and more bloody coins. And as you see, all the cost of research went down to the half. I mean, it was 40. Let me remember, how much was it? Let me see, it was about 44 million food, 8 million wood, and 540 silver. That's insane. There is no way I would spend that much of resources in this. Literally no way. So we use the equipment, not on this one, this one, and it goes down to 21. It's the half resources. It's a lot. It's a lot. So after you build your architect equipment and hit level 30, your priority is to build this equipment. It's gonna be really, really helpful. Don't do the mistake I did. I did a bunch of research without the equipment. Big mistake. So, if you have any, as far as I remember, most of you are. It's gonna be saved in my channel, so you can see, so you can watch it again if you want. Now, in any case, I can do a stream again whenever you want, and continue with the informations. It depends on your time, and actually whenever you want to do it. We probably should arrange a time again, if you want. Okay. Then we talk about it in game. So, okay, I guess we talk later, right? And if you want any other informations, just ask. We talk later. Be online when Mermaid is up. Okay? See you later.